Hi there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today we're going to stamp this cozy scene using some stamps from our sponsor, Rubber Stamp Tapestry. You can find them online at pegstamps.com, and you're just going to need a variety of fall stamps like pumpkins and berries and things like that. I'm also going to use the Fireside Christmas stamp set that I designed for them a couple years ago, and I'm going to use a fireplace part in the fire. Now I'm inking this up with a really pale ink. Now I'm using tea dye from Distress. I would recommend even going lighter than that if you have like antique linen or any super light gray or tan ink you have. You can even stamp it on a scrap paper first and then stamp it on your final cardstock. You just want to be able to see where everything is so you can do your stamping of your pumpkins and garland and whatnot, because you're going to be masking that and then re-stamping your fireplace again later. So you just want to get a groundwork for where your overstamping is going to go. And then I just used a compass. You can trace something that's a small circle, basically to make a wreath shape over the mantle, because I think it's pretty to have a wreath, and I think fall wreaths are so nice and homey. And I'm using this berry stamp as well as a branch just to make this little wreath. And I stamped the berries first in yellow, and then I put my wreath pieces down. And you could also use a marker, and you could draw the wreath part after you've done all your stamping if you just want to be able to precisely tuck it here and there, so that's completely up to you. But I just thought this was a great way to get a lot of the bulk of the wreath and garland down. And then I'm just alternating the yellow, orange, and red inks. Now the ink pads I'm using are, you can use whatever you want, by the way, but these are the Vesrafine Clair inks. And the reason that I'm using these is because you can use these with either water-based or alcohol markers and or watercolors. And I didn't know exactly what I was gonna color with at the beginning, so I figured that's gonna give me a little bit more versatility. Plus, if you're at home and you're like, geez, I'd like to use my watercolors on this, I don't really wanna use alcohol markers, or I don't have watercolor markers, or I don't have this or that, those inks give you more versatility because you can use whatever coloring medium you want. And it's also really easy for you guys to see what colors I'm using because the ink pads show up opaquely. So after you've got all of your images stamped down, you need to make some masks. And to do that, I simply stamped the images onto a post-it note, onto the sticky area, and cut them out, and then just placed them on top of some of the areas I needed to protect, basically areas that were going to overlap the fireplace. Now I'm inking up that same fireplace stamp with the Vesrafine Clair brown ink. I think this was pinecone or acorn. I'm not sure. Whatever one you like better, you can use that. You could do black if you wanted to. Now I'm using a stamp positioner, but I think I must have wiggled it at some point because it did not line up perfectly. But to use these types of stamp positioners, you put a imaging sheet right up into the corner of your stamping tool, then you press your stamp down, keeping that in the corner as well, and then you can place that imaging sheet exactly where you want it to end up stamping. So I'm going to lay that over my project, figure out exactly where that's going to go, and then I'm going to put the corner piece back down. And you could see there how I just kind of wiggled it. You got to be real careful about that. But because you're using such a light color to begin with, even if you're not precise, it's not a big deal. In fact, with a clear stamp like the Fireside Christmas set, you could actually just eyeball it. Just, you know, look straight down over your mount, which I can't do when I'm filming or my head would be in the way. But you can look straight down through your stamp and line it up pretty good, especially with a super light ink underneath. So I did end up with a bit of a double line, but since it was so light, I actually could work that in by making a little shadow. It did make my pumpkins on the hearth levitate a little bit, but well, it's extra spooky. We've got floating pumpkins, right? There's a little extra spooky there. I'm gonna go with that, guys. Thanksgiving, Halloween, so close together. So and that's because my stamp wasn't exactly lined up. I began by, and I'm using the gray set of the Everblend markers from Arteza. You of course can use whatever brand and whatever type of marker you like, and I just colored it an all over stone color. Then I went in with some darker warm grays just to add some shading, and I'm using warm grays as opposed to cool grays because I want this card to have a really cozy warm fall feeling. So the tone of the bias of your color, like using a brown instead of black, is going to give you a warmer, cozier look. Using a warm gray versus a cool or bluish gray is going to give you a warmer and cozier look. So you want to think about your color choice when you are creating your cards to make sure you convey the feeling that you want your card to give. I'm using craft paper as the card base, you'll see as we assemble our card. So that gives it a nice warm and homey, homespun country type of feeling that I'm going for here. Now, I'm going to do the background really simply with some ink blending. Oh, and if you are in America and you have a Dollar Tree store, they now have these little makeup brushes, the toothbrush style ones, for a dollar. This size right here that I'm holding, that I'm doing like the larger inking, that's also, they go from small to like about that size. So you don't get the really big ones, but they do have those ones that are about, I would say, an inch and a quarter wide by inch and a half long, which will do the trick for a lot of inks. So I just wanted to let you know if you do have a Dollar Tree in your town to check that out. Now, the nice thing about having a good selection of markers is that you can kind of hold your swatches up to your card and fill in any gaps. And I thought I wanted to add a little extra texture and shading. So I use that same dark ink to kind of just scribble around and add a little bit of shading for the pumpkins, the shading that they would leave. And because the pumpkin peg stamps have these cute little vines with them in the sets, I thought it would be nice to tuck those in here and there because it gives it a little bit of character. And then any of the little leaves from the berries and from the pumpkin vines, I went in and colored with my markers. Now I used one of the larger ink blending brushes that I had bought at a stamp show just to rouge in the color in the background. And you can also use your color dusters. You've had, you know, use a sponge. It doesn't really matter what you use to put your ink down. It's whatever you're used to and whatever you're comfortable with. I've been using these a lot because they just work really well. And then to put a little pattern, like a wallpaper, in the background, because I thought it needed something, I just used the same color ink and I just went through a stencil right on top. So, you know, you can do that. You don't have to. If you think it's too busy, then skip it. It's your card. You do whatever you want to do. I will say that the smaller little makeup brushes that I thought were kind of a waste, I didn't really like them, work really well when you're using a stencil and you need to get into those like little gaps and nooks and crannies. So you don't have to make like really elaborate masks. You can just kind of sneak in there with them. And then I found a marker that was pretty close to the color of ink that I used, and I used a brush tip marker there because it's just easier to blend out, and I just did some shading and flicked out from the shadow areas just to give it a kind of a soft shadow behind all the wreath and garland and fireplace area, and that just pushes it away from that pattern background a little bit more. I went with a Happy Thanksgiving stamp from the Happy stamp set from Rubber Stamp Tapestry, and I wish I had left it alone just with stamping it. I really wanted it embossed title, but I didn't have a good just plain teal, and so I used this kind of verdigris powder, which is pretty, but it just didn't stand out from the peach as much as I wanted it to. You'll see how I deal with that later, but there it just kind of like fades in. It's too close to the color of the wall, I think. It's almost a perfect match for that. But anyway, I notched that strip of paper, and I've used some teal eyelets to adhere it onto the paper, onto the card base, and I really didn't use any pattern paper because the wallpaper, I feel like, had enough pattern and texture there. I wanted to add a couple embellishments because I've spent so much time on this card. I really wanted it to, I wanted it to be a little extra special. So I'm putting these little resin embellishments. I think they're from close to my heart. I picked them up at a stamp show this summer, and I just put those on around the banner just to accent it a little bit. And I did use some markers to kind of add some shadow and some highlights and try to make the title or the sentiment a little bit more prominent. I also used some opaque paint pens to go in and just add some shine onto some of the berries, add some highlights and that sort of thing. So you could do that with gel pens, you can do that with paint pens. I'm adding some little texture with a gray paint pen to the stones. This is opaque pens, like paint pens, are wonderful if you have like a mistake anywhere because they'll cover up your mistakes. And sometimes when you're scene building, it takes a lot of time and you can easily make an error towards the end, and that's a great way to fix it. If you want to find the stamps I used, you can check out our sponsor, Rubber Stamp Tapestry. Look them up at pegstamps.com. Please give me a thumbs up before you go. Thanks for watching. Until next time, happy crafting.